I'm going to show you how to build 13 shortcuts all geared towards YouTube. How to open any YouTube link you see on a social media platform directly in the YouTube app, quick access to your subscriptions, searching YouTube, your library, and if you're a YouTube creator, how to quickly get the link from your last video published, how to choose one of your recent 10 videos and jump directly to the edit page, and pulling the title and link of your latest videos with a little emoji and then sharing that on social media. We'll start with 7 shortcuts to make watching YouTube easier and then 6 shortcuts for creators. The first shortcut is watch in YouTube. You know how typically when you see a YouTube link on a social media platform, it'll load in the in-app browser and then you're not logged in, you can't comment or like or subscribe to the person's channel. Well, with this shortcut, you can tap and hold on any YouTube link, tap the share via so it brings up the share sheet, and you'll see here I put the watch in YouTube shortcut. When I tap that, it'll open this video in the YouTube app. So now I can like, comment, subscribe to the channel, and all of that. Of course, links to all these shortcuts will be in the video description. You can just download them there. But let me also show you how to build it from scratch. I'm going to hit the plus button, and I'm going to tap the eye icon at the bottom of the shortcuts menu. This toggle right here, show in share sheet, this is what I want to enable. Now it's going to pull content from the share sheet. Now I can actually specify what it pulls. Maybe I just want it to grab URLs because that's what we're doing. It's YouTube links. I'll hit done. And if there's no input, I could choose something like get clipboard. So if I copy a YouTube URL, the shortcut can also use that. Now I'm going to add an action and I'm going to search for expand. This is a helpful shortcuts action because it will actually expand any kind of shortened URL to the original or full link. Next, we're going to search for another action, and this is replace text. We'll get into more advanced shortcuts soon, but replace text is a powerful tool. Now, what we want to do here is replace blank. I'm going to tap in this blank spot right here, and I'm actually going to type replace HTTPS, the very beginning of the URL, with the word YouTube. And then we just need to add one more step. I'll search for open URL. I'll add open URLs. And what this does is it will take the YouTube link that we're sharing into the share sheet, expand it, replace the beginning HTTPS with the word YouTube, and that tells the iPhone or iPad to open this link in that app. And then the final step is to open that updated link so it will automatically open the YouTube video in the YouTube app. Then if you want to make sure that shortcut is at the very top of your list, go to a link, tap the share via, and then scroll all the way down. You see I have lots of shortcuts listed here. I'll go to edit actions, and here you can actually press the green plus button to move an action to the very top. I'll add one just so you can see. Pressing the green plus button then puts it in my favorites, and now that shortcut will be quickly accessible whenever I pull up the share sheet. Again, links down below to download these shortcuts and run them on your device. Now the next few shortcuts are really going to be based on URL schemes, or basically just opening a URL that then sends you directly to the YouTube app in a specific place. For instance, if I want to quickly open the watch later queue, I can just tap this shortcut, and you see it'll jump me right to the YouTube app in my watch later queue. This is a single step shortcut. All you have to do is enter this URL, basically the full youtube.com URL /playlist?list=WL or watch later. To add this action, you would just search in the search box for open URL and then tap where it says URL here and type that out, or you can copy and paste it, and that's it. That's the entire shortcut. Now I'm gonna show you how to quickly use these kind of one step shortcuts in a menu. But that is the open watch later shortcut. Similarly, you can have one for the show YouTube library. Again, there's the actual custom link. Just use the one action, open URL, put this link, and show YouTube library will then automatically send you to the page that has your history, playlist, your videos, kind of that main U tab in the YouTube app. You can also have one for YouTube subscriptions. Again, one action, open URL. This one is youtube.com/feed/subscriptions. If I run this shortcut, then I automatically go to my subscriptions tab. Again, this works on iPhone or iPad. One more quick URL. This one is to go to YouTube Shorts. That's simply youtube.com/shorts. If I tap that, I'll automatically go to the Shorts feed. Oh, what's up, Ben? Now we're gonna make a menu out of all these actions and then put it in our Today view, or you can use it for your action button, but I'll show you that in a second. One more helpful shortcut is the Search YouTube. Rather than go to the YouTube app, go to the search bar, and then put in your query, this shortcut will actually bring up a little text box. You can type in your search query there, and then it will automatically open the YouTube app with that search term already searched. So let's build this shortcut from scratch. The first thing you're gonna put is ask for input. It's under the scripting heading right here, so I'll tap that first. I wanna ask for text, and width, this prompt doesn't affect the shortcut at all. This is just for your reference. Next, I actually need to add a URL field. This way it formats properly before we open it. I'll tap URL. I'm gonna paste our string of URL that opens the YouTube search. I'm gonna tap the updated text, so that shows up at the end of the URL. I'll hit done. And now this open URLs action is already suggested, but I'll search for it just in case yours isn't suggested. Open URLs, and now when I hit play, a search box comes up. I'll search for MagSafe battery. You'll have to tap allow the first time you run the shortcut. And now it's searched YouTube with that search term. Oh, and look, There's another one of my videos. So now when you want to watch YouTube or search, you have these 6 shortcuts ready to go, quick access to those parts of the app. Well, now what you can do is actually create a YouTube menu. This way you can quickly jump to subscriptions, watch later, or search YouTube right from the shortcuts menu. You can even run this menu from your action button. You see I've placed the YouTube menu here in my action button folder. Then I can jump to any of these parts of YouTube just in a single tap. It'll ask you to allow the first time you run it, and here I am in my watch later queue. Now, if you wanted to build that shortcut menu, actually in my first Shortcuts 101 video, I show you how to build menus. You can check that video out above or in the description. But just to give you an idea what it looks like, I add the choose from menu action. This is what it looks like. If I search for the action choose, you'll see choose from menu right here. You tap that. You can input as many options as you would like. I like adding a little emoji and some text. And then under each part of the menu action, I choose to run shortcut. And then I can choose the individual shortcuts that I already created. This way I don't have to add all those actions here in my menu shortcut. These just run those other shortcuts quickly. Again, if you download all the individual shortcuts I put in the video description and then the YouTube menu shortcut, you'll have this all ready to go just downloading from those links. So those are 7 shortcuts that makes watching YouTube videos way easier. Now here are 6 more shortcuts, especially if you're a YouTube creator and want to pull some of the links to your videos or quickly edit a recent video in one tap. This first shortcut actually gets the link directly to the latest YouTube video that I published. You'll see here, automatically pulls the link and then copies it to my clipboard. Now, in order to make all these creator shortcuts work, you do need your YouTube ID. There are some complicated ways to get that, like going into the page source of your YouTube channel, but there's an easier way. Log into your YouTube Studio account, click Customization in the left sidebar, and then where you see Basic Info, click that, scroll down, and then where it says Channel URL, this string of text right after the channel slash is actually your channel ID. This is what you're going to use in these next set of shortcuts because every YouTube channel actually has a hidden RSS feed where every new video shows up as an RSS item. And Shortcuts does really powerful things with RSS feeds. For instance, if I wanted to get the latest YouTube video from my channel and then get the link, this URL scheme right here is what it looks like to have an RSS feed for your YouTube channel. youtube.com/feed/videos.xml?channel-id=, and that's the ID I just pulled from my YouTube Studio settings. This is the link you'll want to create for your YouTube channel. Again, I'll put this string of text in the video description if you just want to copy and paste it, and then you have to put your channel ID after that equal sign. And then once you have that, you're going to be using this URL in all the next shortcuts. Now let me show you what you can do now with this RSS feed. I'm going to copy it to my clipboard, and I'll show you how to build this once, and then it applies to all these following shortcuts. I'll hit the plus button to create a new shortcut. I like putting the full URL up at the top just so it's always persistent in the shortcut. Now the next action I'm going to search for is actually RSS. You'll see Get Items from RSS Feed. Here's the top option. That's the one we want. Right now it's set to get 10 items from that RSS feed. We don't want that. I'm going to show you where that comes into play in a moment. I'm actually going to make this go all the way down to 1. And it's automatically going to get the latest item when you choose 1. Next, I'm going to search for the Get URL. I'm going to choose the Get URLs from Input action. And then I'm just going to add a quick look so we can see what this actually pulls. So there's the RSS feed from my YouTube channel. It's getting the last item, the URL from that item, and then it's going to show me in a little window. When I hit play, first time you run it, you'll have to tap allow. And then you'll see the window comes up. There's the URL to my latest video. Now we can do whatever we want with that to make it easy to share. One of the easiest things to do is just copy it to your clipboard. So I'll search for a copy to clipboard. I'll delete the show URL in quick look. And now when I run this, the URL to my latest video is automatically on my clipboard. This way, if I wanted to put it in a social media post, all I have to do is paste and automatically there's the URL. So that's what the latest YouTube video shortcut does. Gets the URL for your latest video, puts it on your clipboard. Now you can also build this out a little more. Same URL, this is the RSS feed for my channel. And then I'm going to leave the RSS action to 10 items. I want it to get the last 10 videos from that RSS feed. Then I'll add an action, choose from list. If you search in the action box for here, you'll see it come up as choose from list. That's that action. Again, I'll make it so you can download this shortcut and replace the channel ID quickly when you import it. And then this will work for your YouTube channel. So I'll have the option to choose one of the latest 10 videos. It'll get that URL and then copy it to the clipboard. So if I click play on this, you'll see a menu comes up with my 10 latest videos. Now I can quickly pull the URL for any of my latest 10 items, and of course you can increase this number to as high as you want. Now these next two shortcuts are really powerful, especially to quickly edit your recent video. Same URL, again this is the RSS feed for my channel. I'm getting the last item, so get 1 from the RSS feed. And this is where this one differs. I'm actually going to split the URL. Again, to get that action, you do split text. That's what that action looks like there. And you want to split it by a question mark V equals, no spaces. Then the next action is get last item. To do that, that action is under the scripting heading, get item from list. So get last item from the split text. I choose to set a variable here. Again, you don't have to do that. You can choose a magic variable, but just did that so it's easier to see here in the shortcut. And then I'm actually going to put a new URL here, the studio URL, and put the video ID in the middle of that URL. So if you were typing this out, studio.youtube.com/video/ choose the previous action there, then choose the variable video ID slash edit. And then here I have an if statement, because depending on your device, it will either open in Safari or in a web view right here on your device. To do this if statement, you can search for the if action. Of course, it's under scripting. And I'll tap whatever is here. It might be different on your device right now. But I'll tap if input, and then I can choose device details. Tap that again, and you'll see there's a lot of different options here. I can choose device type, hit the X, and then you can choose which device, Mac, iPhone, iPad. So that's how you create an if statement with device type. This way you can run the shortcut on both your Mac and your iPhone and iPad. Now inside that if statement, if it's a Mac, I have open URL, so we'll open a Safari web browser directly to this video to edit. Otherwise, it's gonna show a web view here on my iPad or iPhone. I'm gonna jump over to my Mac so you can see what it looks like here. If I run this edit last video shortcut, it's actually going to open a Safari web browser, a new tab, directly to my last video already on the edit screen. Went directly to it. And if you run that on your iPad or iPhone, you'll get a web view. Now the next shortcut I have is basically the same thing, but it gets 10 items, and then I can choose which video I want to edit. I'll jump over to the Mac again to run this one. When I run it, you'll see a menu come up with my 10 latest videos. Let's say I want to edit this video. I hit done, and now it's going to open a new tab in Safari to edit that particular video. And here it is, ready to edit. Again, I'll make it as easy as possible down in the video description, putting all the information you need to build these shortcuts, or just download it and then replace it with your channel ID. Our last two shortcuts. This one right here is similar to our get link for latest YouTube video, but I've added a little more text so it's nicer to share. Using the same RSS feed for my channel, it gets the last item, and then I actually add a get name from URL. This will get the title of the video. I use a replace text action to remove the dash YouTube part of the URL, and then I format a little text block. I like adding a little TV emoji, new video colon, and then it gets the updated text, which is the name of the video, and the video URL. So when I run this, it gets the name of the latest video and the link as my little beginning part, and now copies this to my clipboard so I can post this on social media, send it in an email, whatever I need. And finally, if you want to quickly upload a video, whether it's on your iPhone, iPad, or Mac, I have another if statement here. If you're on iOS, it'll open the YouTube app to the upload page, and if you're on a Mac, it'll open it to the YouTube upload page. Tap to run. Then I can choose a recent video to upload to my YouTube channel. And on my Mac, use the URL studio.youtube.com/channel/upload. Then it will open to my main studio page and I'm ready to upload. So those are 13 shortcuts for viewing and creating on YouTube. You can download them all in the video description and adjust them to your channel. And if you want to learn even more basics about building shortcuts, I have this video right here. It walks you through building them step by step, including those menus. And YouTube thinks you're going to love this video down here. You should check it out. But before you do, hit subscribe, hit the like button, and leave a comment below if you have any questions about building your own shortcuts. And let me know what other shortcuts you'd like to see built here on the channel. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.